Hello. Data recovery is critical in cyber recovery, and it's very important to bring systems back online with minimal downtime. To achieve that goal, recovery to an alternate DD system can help customers bring systems back to business as quickly as possible. This video describes the reverse sync process, where data is recovered from the Vault DD to the production DD system, including recovery of the data from the production DD using NetWorker that's installed on the production site. In our use case here, on the production site, we have NetWorker 19.8 build 40, and we have configured production DD as the target for all backups. We have added Windows Server as the client on the production site for file system backup. Windows Server is also configured as the client in the Silver policy. File system backups are targeted to the demo data pool, whereas Bootstrap backup is targeted to Bootstrap backup. Both backups have already successfully completed. Here is the production DD called ddveprod.tme.local, and in the vault we have ddvevault.tme.local. Both data domain systems are running DDoS 7.11. From the PuTTY session on the production DD, execute the command mtreelist to check the list of available mtrees. From the resulting list, we can see that the mtree called NVE is used for all NetWorker backups, and that the used capacity is 19 gigabytes. Replication is already configured for this mtree and targeted to the Vault DD. In PowerProtect Cyber Recovery, a policy has already been created for the NetWorker policy named NetWorker Demo. The data has been replicated to the Vault using the CR policy. A copy of the data has been analyzed by CyberSense. We can see that the last analysis of the copy is good, so we'll use it to recover the NetWorker on the production DD system. From the Vault DD's CLI, run the mtreelist command to check the list of mtrees. The mtree called NVE replication vault is the target mtree for the mtree NVE in the production DD, and its status is RO for read only. The mtree that ends with dash repo is the copy that we used to analyze the data. Let's create a new mtree called NVE restore vault. We'll use this mtree as the source to replicate the data from the vault to production. For that, we'll need to create a replication pair using the replication add source command. Run the same command on the production DD. On the production DD, run the command replication show config to check the replication configuration. Use the replication modify command to change the replication connection host for the pair that we just created. In this demo, we are going to use the secondary NIC of the Vault DD and the primary NIC of the production DD for the replication pair we just created. You can also use the secondary NIC of the production DD if required. To initiate the replication from the Vault DD, run the replication initialize command. From a cyber recovery PuTTY session, log in as cyber recovery security officer or CRSO admin using the command crcli login -u CRSO. After logging in, run the crcli policy list command. From the command output, we can identify the copies available. We are going to recover the NetWorker data from the copy that we analyzed earlier using CyberSense. Because we've already created the replication pair, we can now recover the data using the action recover to alternate. This replicates the data from the mtree called NVE restore vault on the Vault DD to the mtree called NVE restore production on the production DD. Here we see that the recover to alternate command completes successfully. navigate to the production DD CLI to check the size and status of the M tree that we used and which is in the read-only state. Because we can't use a read-only M tree, let's create another M tree called data/col1/nve-restore-production-final and do a fast copy of the read-only M tree. Fast copy is a feature in DD that creates a snapshot of the ROM tree and replicates it to the destination. Now, the M tree needs to be converted to a DD boost storage unit. To do this, run the DD boost command, where boost 1 is the DD boost user that is configured in the production DD system for the M tree called data/col1/nve-restore-production-final. This is the brand new NetWorker server that is deployed in the production site with the same host name and version. Now let's recover the data in the server with the replicated data from the vault. Right-click the device, click New Device Wizard, and select the data domain as the device type. On the Configuration Options tab, select Add a New Data Domain System, and enter the production data domain's fully qualified domain name. In the DD Boost credentials area, update the current DD Boost user and password in the DD system. Enable the Configure Secure Multi-Tenancy option, select the storage unit that we converted from the replicated M tree, and click Next. Select both the folders that were originally used in the production networker and click Next. Clear the Configure Media Pools for Devices checkbox because we are not going to configure it. Make sure that the Label and Mount Device After Creation checkboxes are also cleared. Here we'll clear two additional checkboxes, Gather Usage Information and Receive SNMP Trap Events because they are required only for monitoring. Keep the default options for the rest of the tabs and click Configure. Both the devices and the data domain are added successfully. From the NetWorker server PuTTY session, run the NSRMM command to display the list of devices. Run the scanner command with the device name to get the bootstrap ID. Make a note of the device name and the bootstrap ID. Starting from NetWorker 19.8, we need to perform an additional step before running the NSRDR command to initiate the disaster recovery process. From the NetWorker console, under Server, right-click the name of the server and click Properties. Change the server state from Active to Disaster Recovery and click OK. Switch back to the NetWorker CLI and execute the NSRDR command to initiate the disaster recovery process and confirm the device name and bootstrap ID. Confirm Y to recover the client index files as well. The recovery process will run for a few minutes. The processing time depends on the size and number of clients. At each prompt, answer Y to accept the default. After the recovery process has completed successfully, open the NetWorker Management Console and launch the NetWorker application. Select the devices where we can see that both the devices are in a mounted state. Windows Server appears under Clients in the Protection tab. Select the Media tab, right-click the volume, and click Show Save Sets, which lists the available backups that can be used to recover the client. This concludes our demo of the reverse sync process, in which we've recovered data from the Vault DD to the Production DD system and recovered the data from the Production DD using NetWorker that's installed on the production site. Starting from CR 19.13, reverse replication can be done from GUI as well. Navigate to Recovery tab in the CR GUI and click Alternate Recovery. Thanks for watching.